Hey, Bishop Wooden here, inviting you to meet me tonight at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. But before I talk to you about tonight's service, just want to follow up a little bit on what we talked about on last week. You remember the concern was that Mr. Dinkins, a young man, the young 24-year-old who was killed in a confrontation with the police, our concern was that the reports that were reported in the newspaper were true. And if they were true, then it appeared that Mr. Dinkins was denied due process. Well, since that time, we've received a report from the police chief, C.L. Deck Brown, police chief, that appears that the stories that were initially reported in the newspapers weren't true, were indeed false, that there was a confrontation between Officer Twitty and Mr. Dinkins, and that Mr. Dinkins was shot multiple times in the chest and in the arms, although the final autopsy report has not yet been completed. I want to compliment the people who live in the Bragg Street area, in that area of Raleigh, for not going out and burning your own community, not going out and doing damage in your own home, but for keeping calm and waiting to see how things work out. I will say this. I miss the late, great Sheriff John Baker, who would come to our community and would warn the young men and the young women to stay out of that life, to stay out of the system, to not have warrants and not live your life in a manner where the police will be chasing you or looking for you. Because, you know, when you get into that life, my friends, things happen. And Sheriff Baker would say this: just stay out of the system. While I see you here at church, I can be warm, I can help you, and I can warn you. But once I have to arrest you, once you're in the system, it's a whole new ball game. And if there are any young African-American men watching, any moms and dads, show this to your children and encourage them. Abide by the law. Don't get involved in that system. Listen, being law-abiding sometimes is difficult, sometimes it's hard, and you know, many times it appears that you can make more money breaking the law and taking shortcuts than you can if you sell drugs or get involved in things like that. But my friends, people who get involved in that life, they are met with a tragic end. Sometimes it's legal, sometimes it's illegal. Sometimes it's a situation where it is a lawful killing or shooting by the police. Sometimes there are times when, if we have to be honest, it is unlawful. We don't know what this is, but the evidence seems to show at this time that Officer Twitty was engaged in a confrontation with Mr. Dinkins, and we're praying for the family. We're praying for the family of Mr. Dinkins, and we're praying for the family of Officer Twitty. Now, I want you to come out tonight. I want you to come out tonight and hear the word of the Lord. I've been talking about a sinister plan that was put in place by an evil woman named Alice Bailey. Alice Bailey has been dead for 65 years, but she put a 10-point plan in place, a New World Order for the destruction of Christianity. And my friends, you've seen some of her plans. You've seen it in the news, whether you knew that was what you were looking at or not, such as take God and prayer out of the education system, reduce parental authority, destroy the Judeo-Christian family structure. I mean, things that are going on in this day and time. Other plans that she says, make sex free. And promote sexual promiscuity and promote and make divorce legal and easy. We're seeing the homes are being ravished today through divorce. And tonight I'm talking about point number 6, make homosexuality an alternative lifestyle. You need to hear what this lady said. She's been dead for 65 years, but her diabolical plan reminds me of the diabolical plan that Willie Lynch put together, and he's been dead much, much longer, and he put together a plan to divide African Americans, and his plan is alive and well today, and he put his plan in place when slavery was the law of the land. I want to show you in scripture that they're using psychology, they're using the media, they're doing all kinds of things to reprogram our thinking and to get us to distrust the Bible and distrust God's word. And my friends, I'm staying with the word of the Lord. For heaven and earth shall pass away before one jot or one tittle of God's word fail. I'll see you tonight. God bless.